So you don't believe my story, but back when I worked in a dispensary, I didn't work in the dispensary. It's distinctly not. Distinctly? Oh, what's going on here either? Distinctly, I worked in the lobby to not be associated with. I worked technically through a completely different company on paper. You only know that it's a dispensary because this happened. Otherwise, you would have no idea. They offered me a position outside the company, higher than the company, as a efficiency expert for companies in general. And I turned it, you don't believe this, but this is what happened. And I turned it down. It was significantly more money, more responsibility, more impressive, because I just wanted to be a stand-up comedian and have an excuse to get stoned and write comedy. And so then they said, well, how about you be the manager? And then I said no again, and they were like, what the hell, dude? Why do you keep saying no to more money and like better everything? And I was like, because I seriously want as little responsibility as possible so that I may get stoned at work at a dispensary, which you can, and write comedy. And now I've had. I'd label it like an epiphany from above about basically a direct God current into my, obviously into my creative genius mind. I have decided to continue writing comedy and target certain niche markets. Just if you want to know my marketing behind my next maneuver, I was thinking, you know what you don't see enough of? Stand up for babies. Stand up for particularly apt babies. And then I was thinking, like, what goes with babies? Dogs. So I was thinking, like, and psychic dogs. Like dogs with mind reading, kind of like human deciphering. It's a real niche market, but I think it's gonna set me apart, distinctly apart from the other comedy writers. I was thinking about of pursuing this. You said I need to have work goals, so I'm telling you one of them, and I think it's fuck, it's viable. I think it's thriving. I mean, you don't even know. What if one baby tells one particularly apt baby communicates through baby sign language, my joke, to the other baby, and then that baby demands for, you know, my comedy only to be on TV? Now you, we don't even know. Oh, we don't even know. This could spread like wildfire, I'm just saying. So I'll get back to writing comedy one day. Da-da-da-da-da. Ah! Thank you. Thank you.